Is plastic pollution finally at an end? Hello everyone. Welcome to the Isle of Knowledge. Today, we'll discuss one of the most pressing environmental issues, plastic waste, its impacts, and the recent scientific discoveries that could assist us in solving the issue. If you think these contents are useful, kindly subscribe to my channel, like, and share. Thank you very much for your support. Plastic is a groundbreaking invention. It's durable, cheap, and multifunctional. However, at the same time, it pushed our planet to the near brink of disaster. Scientists have discovered microplastics almost everywhere on Earth, from the Mariana Trench to the highs of the Everest, undoubtedly confirming the fact that they are harming nearly all life around us. Humans are a selfish species, which is unfortunate but true. Most of us appear to be unconcerned about the consequences of our actions on animals, let alone other people in our environment. Each second, we buy around 1 million plastic bottles. Since 90% of the plastic was never recycled, we regularly dumped enormous amounts of plastic into the environment. The annual global plastic emission is estimated to be around 300 million metric tons. It has also reached a point where it is estimated that by 2050, our oceans will contain more plastic than fish. Besides placing it in a landfill, burning is the most popular way to dispose of plastic. This method is not recommended by most environmentalists, since it is expensive, energy intensive, and releases toxic gases into the atmosphere. Glycolysis, pyrolysis, and methanolysis are three alternative industrial processes that require a significant amount of energy and are examples of the above methods. Over the last 60 years, it is estimated that the world has produced 9 billion tons of plastic. Only 7% of them have been recycled, while 12% have been burned. The remaining 79% has accumulated in landfills or has found its way elsewhere in the environment. Unfortunately, one of the most common types of plastic, polyethylene terephthalate, is notoriously difficult to degrade. That is not to say that plastics cannot decompose, they could. But it takes a very long time. Plastic bottles in waste might take up to 450 years to decompose. When plastic waste is discarded, it degrades into microplastics, which then enter marine and terrestrial ecosystems, and even enter our food. Plastics can be harmful to humans, potentially affecting fertility, hormonal, metabolic, and central nervous systems. As people became more aware of the crisis, significant efforts were also made to avert the disaster. Some of the initiatives include reducing plastic usage, introducing alternatives, and outright bans. However, some recent scientific discoveries are expected to have a significant impact on our battle against plastic pollution. Here are some potential scientific solutions to plastic waste that could possibly save the planet. plastic eating bacteria. Plastics are not natural substances. Hence, there are no natural organisms that can effectively break them down. These substances are generally known as xenobiotics. Bacteria are not familiar and do not have access to the chemical bonds found in plastic materials. However, in 2016, a Japanese scientist discovered a plastic-eating enzyme capable of degrading polyethylene terephthalate, the most widely used plastic. This research is still at the initial stage. Therefore, the bacteria, named Idionella sakiensis, may not immediately reduce the tens of millions of tons of plastic waste that enter the environment each year. However, recent breakthroughs suggest that, one day, it may be possible to build industrial-scale facilities capable of producing enough enzymes to combat plastic pollution. An attractive solution. Scientists have developed a magnetic coil that attracts microplastics found in the ocean. It breaks down the debris using nanotechnology. The best part is that it does so without harming marine life in any way. These tiny coils are covered in nitrogen and manganese. When they come into contact with oxygen, they begin to degrade the plastic. In a controlled study, it was discovered that these nanocoils can reduce microplastics by up to 50% in 8 hours. This could be one of our last hopes of recovering our planet from the destruction we did. Fueling the future. An Australian company has invented a technique that turns plastic into oil. The process, known as catalytic hydrothermal reactor, melts non-recyclable plastic and transforms it into fuel. The technique is similar to using a pressure cooker and may convert any type of single-use plastic into waxes and oils. They may reuse 20,000 tons of plastic every year, reducing the quantity of plastic that would otherwise end up in the ocean and landfills. The disadvantage of the technology is that it emits carbon dioxide. An earthy solution. A fungus called Aspergillus tubingensis has the ability to break down polyurethane. A British biotech engineer, working for a biomanufacturing company, accidentally found the fungus. While investigating a variety of fungi, she discovered that one of the mushrooms had broken through the container lid and was growing on it. The plastic sponge that was supposed to contain the fungus had been eaten by the same fungus by breaking it down and assimilating it like any other food. The project's original goal was to assess various fungal strains for use in bio-based insulation panels, but the fungus appetite has pushed them on a new pathway. Now, the company is working to improve the strain to make it an even more effective digester that might aid in eliminating plastic waste. Solutions from the ocean. One of the key ways to tackle the plastic catastrophe is the use of bioplastic. This particular kind of plastic is created using renewable, bio-based materials. Ironically, the remedy came from the very source that has suffered the most as a result of excessive plastic waste. An Indonesian startup collaborates with seaweed growers to create packaging from seaweed. This material is used to package food and can be completely dissolved in hot water and even edible. Even though the country produces millions of tons of seaweed each year, this method has some drawbacks. One is cost, as seaweed wrapping is roughly 5 times the price of standard packing. To protect the seaweed, it also needs more wrapping, which is a relatively unsustainable strategy. However, researchers remain optimistic about the future of bioplastics as a plastic substitute. Plastic pollution is a global system failure with enormous economic and social costs. Above innovations could address the plastic problem from different perspectives. However, manufacturing, buying, and consuming fewer plastics will always be the best solutions. Yes, it is economical, light, and durable. But we need to assess the impact this material has on the environment. To confront the environmental catastrophe before us, everyone's commitment will be required. And we all have a role to play. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.